If you're somebody who wants to achieve your 2023 goals, then this video is a must for you. Hi there everybody, this is Neha Bhatt here. I'm a communication specialist and NLP trainer, and I help people removing their blocks with the help of NLP and some spiritual methods just within a few minutes. We have a lot of testimonials in this channel as well. You may please go ahead and see that after this video. All right, so goals. Oh my God, 2023 is about to arrive, or we are almost reaching there. It's very important that we get an understanding as to how to achieve your 2023 goals and with ease and with more comfort, you know. So yes, I've used the word comfort, but in this entire time I'll be talking more about comfort as well. So stay with me. If you want to achieve your 2023 goals, make sure that you subscribe to this channel as well and hit the bell button so that we are regularly connected. Okay, now here's the thing. How to achieve your 2023 goals. A lot of people, they write goals, but at the end of the day, you know, we sometimes forget on the 15th of January that we don't know where the notebook is, where we wrote our goals, you know. So it's very important that you understand a step-by-step method. So first thing first, what you need to do, if you're really, really willing to achieve your goals, stop looking at people who you feel are successful than you, and you're feeling a comparison and you're feeling jealous out of them. Stop looking at these people. Just stop it, stop it, stop it. It's not at all healthy. It brings a lot of self-doubt. It brings a lot of self-hatred. It brings a lot of self-pity as well. We start to question ourselves. So first thing first, stop looking at people on social media. They have their own journey, you have your own, and you don't know what back work they are doing to get there. So you need to do the back work, right? It's the front is what right now, for example, you're seeing this video is one thing, but behind the scenes is totally different, you know, maybe making a script and preparing and, you know, making sure, okay, what dress I'm going to wear or how I'm going to speak, what is the order of it? Why am I making this video today? There's a lot of things that is on the background. So till the time you don't know how to understand the psychology of a person who is actually getting the results, you will not be able to model that person. Also, you will end up only feeling very jealous, or you'll feel more self-pity, and we don't want that. So just cut the crap, remove it out of your system right now, okay? No more comparisons, first thing first. Now, the second thing is that I would highly, highly recommend, that actually comes from the first point, why you're looking at other people is because you don't have a mentor. You're not a part of any community which is going towards one direction. All the people are going towards one direction. Now, I have been a part of communities for more than 15 years now. And whenever I have not been a part of the community, I have seen differences, I have seen challenges, I have seen that I kind of just get in my head. And I've learned from Tony Robbins, my mentor, when you're in your head, you're dead. So when you look at other people on social media, it's because you don't have one guide to tell you, hey, this is where you need to look at, right? So it's very important to hire a mentor, to be a part of a community, and to be a part of that one vision that all of you are going for, right? It's not just about communities. It's not just about joining a community. It's about more about that you have one vision, okay? All of you are thinking on a very similar level, on a very similar page, very similar thoughts, maybe very similar ideas as well, maybe very similar energy as well. But on the first point, like I mentioned, when you look at social media, you don't know what that person's energy is. You don't know what that person's background is. And let's say you're looking at five different people, very different energies, very different thought process, very different vision as well, probably, right? So second point is that hire a mentor and be a part of the community. You can be a part of our community as well if you would like to, especially if you want to learn more about NLP. And if you want me as a mentor in your life, very much possible, get in touch with us, okay? But if you want somebody else who can help you with some other goals of yours, go ahead and be a part of that journey, okay? The third is, you definitely need to have 3 months, 6 months goals, but I would also say the moment you watch this video, think about it. What is it that you want in the next coming week? What is it? And is that goal measurable for you? Right? So be crystal clear of what goal you want to achieve in this week. Okay. Pick up a project, for example. Okay. You know what? This week, I'm just going to focus on this. All the other things are going to kind of align with it. But this is my 1 week's goal. Okay, this is my top goal, and all the other things that I'm doing is it's just going to align. It's going to take me there. Okay, it could be health, it could be relationship, or whatever it is. For example, preferably that it is measurable. If it is measurable, it becomes more easier for you to get there. Now, I want you to really eat, breathe, sleep your goal, at least for 1 week. Now, there's a huge chance, because you're kind of pushing yourself, you may not be able to achieve it as well, okay? So let's say on the third day, you may not be able to achieve whatever you're looking at, whatever you thought of. Let's say till third day, there is nothing. There is nothing that is coming up from the universe. It's okay. Convert your can't, oh my God, I can't do it, oh my God, it's not happening, to creativity. Do something creative. Maybe in your own field, or maybe something else. Channelize your energy. Don't just stop there, okay? Channelize your energy. Because always remember this one thing. Whatever you are doing, it might take a little bit of time as well. But at the end of the day, you are pushing yourself, right? You're stretching yourself, okay? So I've learned something many years ago. If you make the possible possible, there are lots of invisible forces around us which we can't see, okay? And they're going to make the impossible possible for you. It's as simple as that. But are you ready, and are you willing to take the or do the possible possible, right? For example, my possible is that I have to make videos. I have to, you know, make posts. I have to do a little bit of marketing, right? Some part my team member does. I have to, you know, for example, do my rituals, right? Am I doing all these things or not? Or am I thinking the third day, oh my God, nothing is happening, something is wrong, something is wrong? No. Yes, after 2 weeks, if something is not working, then maybe something is wrong. But even after 3 days, something is not working, you keep going with your rituals. Do you feel stable all day? Do you feel excited and, you know, you're kind of looking forward to it all day, right? If you're not feeling stable, if you're feeling restless all day, which means that your rituals are not right, right? If by the end of the day, you're not able to sleep, your still thoughts are going on. So which means that you haven't put your can't into creativity, which means you haven't really channelized your energy, right? There could be times you may not be getting the results immediately, right? But you've got to channelize your energy, and you've got to know one thing for sure. If you make the possible possible, the invisible forces will make the impossible possible for you, okay? Now, the next is that there will be times that you will have some obstacles as well in this journey. Yes, there's a huge possibility you will have obstacles, right? Just one thing, I want you to start to make your obstacle as a sign to come out of comfort zone. Obstacle could be anything. Like, I'm a trainer, so I know I have regular obstacles. Sometimes it is technical, sometimes it is monetary as well. Sometimes it could be my environmental obstacle. So what do I do in that case? Just know one thing, that you continue to do the third point that I just mentioned. Eat, breathe, sleep, that 1 week goal of yours, okay? It's gonna give you a little bit of stress, definitely. But whenever it is going to that level of stress, once again, get back to yourself, breathe, do your rituals, and make sure that you are stretching yourself. But the fourth point that I'm talking about here is, because the third and fourth is very related, the fourth point is that you need to come out of your comfort zone. And any obstacle that is coming, it is just to make you come out of your comfort. Your comfort could be, you know, for example, my comfort could be, let's suppose that, you know, I'm just making reels, okay? I'm not making long videos, for example. Now, when I'm making long videos, let's suppose I'm not getting the ideas. Let's say I have to sit down, research. For example, right? So that is just an obstacle, but it is making me come out of my comfort zone. For example, I'm in a place and there's a power cut. It's a comfort zone because I'm always sitting in the house and making videos. Maybe I need to go out and do something. Just examples I'm giving to you, okay? Maybe there could be a comfort zone on your pricing. Let's say if you talk about business, you're not earning, you're not saving because your pricing is not good, for example. You need to step up. You need to say that, okay, this is it. Enough is enough. I'm going to charge this much. And I'm going to do whatever it takes. Like, whatever it takes is my favorite line that I've been using a lot of late, especially for 2023 goals. Whatever it takes, whatever the hell it takes, right? Whatever it takes, you gotta make sure that you get what you want. Because at the end of the day, it is not about achieving something. It is more about being fulfilled in what you do, right? If you have a capability, if you have a skill, you have a talent, it needs to be channelized, right? And this fourth point, that it will make you come out of your comfort zone, you know, just know that obstacle. Oh wow, there's an obstacle. Yay! I'm coming out of my comfort zone. So you can kind of anchor yourself as well. The moment there is an obstacle, there is a glitch, there is a problem. Wow, I'm coming out of my comfort zone, right? So let's say the obstacle could be your own health as well. For example, you're working and you're doing something and your health is a problem. So in that case, you may want to probably, you know, you may want to ask yourself that, okay, why this has happened? What is the intention behind it, right? Am I overdoing everything, right? So every time there's an obstacle, just convert it into, oh wow, I need to come out of my comfort zone, okay? Comfort could be, for example, if you have a health challenge, okay? All of a sudden, you're really going, and then what is happening? All of a sudden, there is a health challenge. And then, what is comfort? Comfort is probably that you're just focused too much on the work, but you're not giving at least 10 minutes or 15 minutes of your time every day for a walk or for yoga or some kind of exercise. You become very comfortable in your body. So maybe you need to go out, step out, do some exercise, right? This is the fourth point. The fifth point is, I would want you to actually be very clear, whatever clarity that you have. Even if you don't have the clarity, write down in the form of a goal that I'm getting clear of my goals. Okay? When there's no clarity, make it a goal. I'm getting clear of my goals. And whatever your goals are, let's say 3 to 6 months, for example, I want you to record it in your own voice and with energy. Okay? For example, one of my goals is that I do meditate every day. Okay? I meditate for 20 minutes every single day and it feels amazing. So add an emotion to it, add a masala to it. For example, one of my goals is, let's suppose one of my goals is to go to Ecuador, okay? And I want to go to Ecuador. I want to travel to a new country in 6 months, okay? I'm going to so-and-so country and wow, it is a zabardast miracle, you know? So add some emotion to it and when you're recording it, actually feel it and say it, okay? And it will take around 5 to 7 minutes for you to record all your goals. Okay, you can do it twice, you can do it thrice as well. What I do is I sometimes record it and then I edit it as well with some music on the background, which helps me in the right frequency, come in the right frequency. And then, you know, when I'm doing that, of course, I get things very fast. So you have to know one thing, that your goals needs to be reminded to you again and again. And that won't just be on a piece of paper, you know. And, you know, like I sometimes write it on a piece of paper as well so that I can carry it. I don't always, and I just keep it in my bag sometimes. But the best is that if you can record your goals and go for a walk with it, you know, go for a walk. Because when you add a physiology to whatever you're wanting, you get it even faster. Okay. One is, okay, you know, I'm achieving these goals. I'm just repeating it is one thing, but when you add a physiology to it, I personally like to do it when I go for a walk. I listen, I repeat, and I go for a quick walk, 10 minutes walk, come back. That's it. It gives me a lot of energy. It gives me, more clarity, and it puts me into action. Okay. And then there's no negative thought at all. Okay. And the last is, which is my, again, super favorite, is let it go. Let it go. I mean, think about it. When you go out somewhere of your house and when you come back, do you sleep with your shoes on? No, right? Similarly, you need to let it go. So how I let it go is, there's a very beautiful song. If you want, you can find it on YouTube as well. It's from Harshdeep Kaur, Rabba Rabba, okay? And it's a very beautiful song. Come in the child pose, if you know how to do the child pose. And maybe by the end of the day, you can just do that every single day when you go to bed, okay? Because whole day you have done a lot of work. Now there is a huge chance a thought might come, you know, depending on how energetic also you're feeling. If you're still feeling very energetic, still it's time to go to bed, right? So just come in the child pose, put that song on and just say, you know what, whatever I could do, I did my best and I'm going to bed. And just talk to the divine and tell him that now you do whatever is required from you to do, right? Because at the end of the day, it is divine power, not just willpower. Your willpower will not work to achieve your goals, I'm telling you. It is, I've tested it last 15 years. I have seen it. I have seen multiple failures in my life. But when you have a mentor or when you even have a divine power, not just a willpower, you will start to achieve your goals even faster. Okay, so let's do a quick recap here. First thing, stop looking at people on social media who are succeeding. I mean, if you want to model them, if you want to learn from them, pick it up, but stop comparing yourself, okay? Second is hire a mentor. If you want to hire me for NLP to achieve your goals and to remove your blocks, more than welcome. Or if you want somebody else, go find it, okay? But do it. And third is eat, breathe, sleep your at least 1 week goal, okay? And then after a week, you can take a break a little bit and then go on, then go on. This is how, if you're going to go, your 2023 goals are going to be achieved 100%. Fourth is, remember that every obstacle that you're going to face, that is just to come out of your comfort zone. Anytime you have an obstacle, say, wow, I'm about to come out of my comfort zone, and feel it in your heart, okay? And fifth is, record your goals and listen to it 2 to 3 times in a day. If you already feel very energetic all day, then just listen once or twice, not more than that, okay? Because you also want to feel more centered and more balanced, okay? You should be able to go to sleep, okay? And the last is, let it go. Everything is not in your control. Remember that. Not everything is going to be in your control ever. Actually, nothing is in your control at the end of the day. So just make sure that when you go to bed, you listen to that music and just let it go. And just tell the divine, you take care of it now. I've done my job. But make sure that you have done yours. Because if by the end of the day, you're still feeling either very high in energy or, you know, a little bit sad, so which means you have not done the work in the daytime, okay? So with that, thank you so much. If you're somebody who wants to achieve your goals and want to raise your vibration, I'm also coming up with my book, Frequency Matters. The book is almost finished, and I'm very excited for it. A lot of people have already booked for the pre-launch. The hard copy, we're going to be releasing it in a few months, but you can start to read the book. You can just apply for it. It is only for 300 rupees at the moment. I'm going to put the link in the description box. Make sure that you buy the book and get on with it, and wish you all the best for achieving your goals in 2023. Thank you. Bye.